Good evening, let's talk it out.
Please speak to Astronaut Stafford.
Sure, Ryan. Go ahead.
Okay, General, were you relieved that Gene Cernan wasn't able to fly the AMU on Gemini 9?
You do your homework very well, don't you?
Yeah.
Well, a little bit, I guess. The main thing is, you know, people say, have you ever had a difficult time in space? That was one of the most difficult. I had the hatch open. Of course, I was pressurized.
Yes.
Gene Cernan was about 18 feet behind me, hanging onto the back end of the spacecraft in his rocket pack, and it was nighttime.
Yes, sir.
Past Australia, and we're out of contact. We didn't have near the communication we had now. And his faceplate was fogged over where he couldn't see. He couldn't even see 6 inches, and I was down to two steps where I would explode him loose. And also, we lost communications one way between us.
All right.
So it was just only Gino, myself, and God up there. We had to go work it out.
Uh-huh.
But from what we learned later on as far as the dynamics and restraints required, probably just as well that he fogged over and I gave him a no-go. In fact, when the sun came up that morning, he still couldn't see. And he'd put up a rear-view mirror out on a docking pedestal. And I looked out, even though I was pressurized, I looked out in the mirror and directed him hand over hand to walk himself back on the rail until I could kind of reach over and get his feet and get him directed in the spacecraft.
Yes, sir. Is that the reason why they canceled the AMU on 12?
That was basically it, due to all the problems that we had had on 9 and really started to find the problems.
I see. Are you still on flight status, or you took yourself off?
Oh, no. I'm on flying status as far as aircraft. I left the astronaut group to be the commander of the flight test center at Edwards, but I'm still in good physical shape to fly in space.
General, what does AMU mean, the initials?
Well, it was an astronaut maneuvering unit. It had, it was powered by hydrogen peroxide for thrusters, had rate gyros in it. Now, one thing you noticed on Skylab, we had a derivative of the AMU, but we flew it inside the Skylab.
Was that thing ever flown? I thought it wasn't.
No, but it was a takeoff from the AMU.
Yeah.
Some of the ideas were later put in Skylab and flown inside the lab around.
Was it successful?
Yes, it used, we knew lots more about it. And we only used nitrogen gas and not the real hot gas for thrusters.
And a derivative of that will be used in the shuttle?
We're planning that as a derivative to use for outside the vehicle.
Mm-hmm. And would you suggest a good aeronautical university?
Well, there's some of the United States.
About the Air Force Academy.
Right, Air Force Academy is good. In fact, the University of Tennessee has got a great aeronautical department. In fact, the detachment is over at Tullahoma in our Air Force
permanently?
Testing laboratory. Yes.
It's there permanently.
Right.
I didn't realize that.
Yes. Purdue, is that any good?
Pardon me?
Purdue University.
Yes. A lot of the astronauts have been there. Gene Cernan, Gus Grissom, Neil Armstrong, Roger Chaffee, quite a few of them.
That's where I'm planning to go. Okay, thank you.
Hey, hold on a second.
Yep.
Where do you go to school now?
CBHS.
Well, you're in a real fine school out there. How did you become so knowledgeable and interested in space?
It was during the flight of Apollo 7, I think, and I just started learning more and more about it. I just kept on learning. I want to be an astronautical engineer. It's derived as aeronautical.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to see accomplished during your lifetime?
Probably commercial flights to the moon or into space. Probably to a space station.
And
as far as that goes.
Do you really think you'll see that in your lifetime?
Probably. I'll probably be around to the year 2040. So I probably will see something near that.
General, do you think this young man is dreaming too much, or will he really see this?
I think that what he's talking about will be a derivative of the shuttle we're going to develop. It'll fly in about 4 years. The shuttle won't do it completely, but it'll be a derivative from the shuttle.
Now, why would you want to go to the moon?
To see what's there, and to sort of develop it.
And in what way would you like to develop it?
Well, who knows what will be found there. Really, we just sort of tapped the surface, and there's a lot more there left untouched. Who can tell?
Yeah. Well, I suppose you're right. General, would you agree with all this gentleman's saying?
Well, I definitely think so. And I'm also amazed at all the background he has looked into. I think it's great.